We are Lewis FC, and we are the only club in the world to dedicate equal resources and playing budget to our women's and our men's teams.
It's the biggest sport in the world. Hundreds of thousands of players, tens of thousands of clubs. But for all its money, for all its exposure, just one can boast the fact that they are truly equal. I'm Sam Ashu in Doha, and this is Football Now. Did you know that 100 years ago, women's football drew more crowds than the men's game in the UK? What about if I also told you that those same women were banned from playing the sport professionally for nearly 50 years? But this didn't just happen in England. Elsewhere, women were prevented from playing football in Brazil for 40 years, Germany for 15, and France for over 40. Today, women's football paints an altogether different picture, doesn't it? But there are still barriers, namely funding. And that's where Lewis FC comes in.
Lewis FC is the greatest football club you've never heard of. It is a football club that puts principles and values and passion right at the heart of it. It is a club that wants to provide for everyone, not just your traditional men's side of a football club, but also the women's side and the youth section. And it believes in giving back to people.
Lewis FC are based here in the southeast of England. They were formed way back in 1885. Their campaign is called Equality FC. Same budget, same pitch, same training ground.
I think it's really important to have equality between the men's and women's budgets, because football's moving forward anyway. We can see that the women's game is becoming more and more valued. And also, I just think it sends a really great message to other companies, other lines of business, other sports to do the same thing.
We go beyond just a men's team. A lot of clubs are just about the men's stuff, where now I can't play against other men's team and their directors and their players are asking me about, is it true that you pay the women the same? And we say yes, and it's something that we're really proud of.
The club stadium is known as the Dripping Pan. It might be small and it might not be glamorous, but it was recently named as Britain's greatest ground.
It's different. No, it's great. There's a really, really good buzz. They make sure there's a great atmosphere. And as somebody that plays here, having the fans back has, you know, is so exciting, and it's definitely a big plus of why you'd want to play for Lewis.
Let's look at one key fact then. A recent report suggesting that 90% of men and women are paid equally at major sporting events. Football, as you probably know, though, doesn't fall into that bracket. Although in September 2021, there was a major breakthrough. The US Soccer Federation offered identical contracts to both its men's and women's national teams. So could this be a new era in the game?
I think that when Lewis FC took the decision to split its revenue equally back in 2017, we assumed that other clubs would follow suit pretty quickly, and they didn't. They still haven't, and this is several years on now. I think that ultimately, although it's been a great decision for us as a club, people are still scared. They still believe that equality is taking something away from the men's side of the club.
Lewis FC isn't just about equality on the pitch, though. They're completely owned by their supporters, with a share in the club costing you anywhere between 60 to 100 euros. Pretty good going, isn't it? 2,000 members have purchased at least one of those shares already. So let's compare this with one of the biggest clubs in the world. None other than Barcelona, their motto being Més que un club, which is based on the fact that they're owned largely by supporters known as socios. So do Lewis FC think they can beat that?
What other football club could you buy into where you can actually spend your money to bring about societal change? Change in gender equality or gender inequality throughout football throughout the world. Also, we are one of a small number of football clubs standing up against gambling sponsorship on shirts. We won't accept it, we won't have it anywhere in the ground. We take a number of stands on various things, and we think people like that. So When I think about the target to be the most owned football club in the world, I think it's entirely doable, and I have absolutely no doubt that we will hit it. I don't know how long it will take, but we will definitely hit it.
Anyone can become an owner, and those owners come from, I think, around 37 different countries around the world. We have 1,800 of them right now. And each of them are starting to sign up because they first hear of our story and they think, hey, that, I want to back that. That's what I did in 2017, long before I worked at the club. I saw this tiny little football club trying to change the world, and I said, hey, I'll probably never go there, but I want that club to know that I backed them. So I became an owner. I think anyone, wherever they are, should also show us that they back us as well and become an owner.
So there we have it then, the world's first and only football club to pay its men and women equally. But most importantly, what do you think at home? Should your club do the same? Let us know using the hashtag FootballNowEqualPay, and we'll see you soon for more Football Now.